has built an amazing thing here, and it is full of things that are passionate to our heart that Mark has made sure would happen. You see, all of the detail has come from Mark. He's placed every aspect of it into this house, from sound, lighting, concrete, color choices. Mark has been the one that's actually made the detail on the inside happen.
Kind of an interesting dynamic, because it's not actually a commercial building, although obviously it is a commercial building. The approach that we've taken to the design and functionality of the building is more like a home. So everything's important. The size of the skirtings and the depth of the fascias and, you know, the carpet that goes down, you know, whether it's double stick or whether it's got underlay. All of those sorts of things that you would consider important in a home, but not so much in a commercial application, doesn't actually apply. It's extremely important for this project.
As long as you're happy.
She's happy. I am more happy. Than happy with it.
Because this actually is a house. It's a home. You know, it's a home for the people of God, and it's a representation of even the character and personalities of both Pastor Peter and Bev and everybody in the congregation. So all of those little things are extremely important, and so it's my job to make sure that they're right.
And the bass keeps running, running, and running, running,
and running, running, and running, running, and running, running, and running, running, and running, running, and running.
Seats are nearly all in.
That's good news.
Come, look at the progress.
Magnificent, aren't they?
Do we have clearance, Clarence?
Roger, roger.
Well, what a great turnout today. Cheers are going in. You know, it's so exciting to see things come together. We're going to be moving into this auditorium on the 1st of July for our 25th anniversary. Obviously, there's a little bit of work to do between now and then, but people are labouring together. Everybody I'm talking to are just so enjoying it. You know, it's absolutely, let's face it, I keep saying it, but it's incredible.
Running, running, and running, running.
Come on, y'all. Let's get ready.
Sid and Mark, we could not have done it without them. And Mark, he's put his hand to it, and he's caused it to be something that has come from our heart and from our spirit.
The whole thing has just gone from scene to scene. Watching Sophie take charge of the concrete trucks, you know, and people who have never lifted a hammer in their entire life getting in there and being part of the construction process. Working up on the roof, you know, 16 and a half metres to the ground. Oh, it's just, it's all scary stuff, but it's just awesome.
Over 90% of what people see and don't see behind the scenes, City Impact Church people have done, which is an incredible, incredible thing. You know, all the service rooms, into the air conditioning room, into the computer rooms, into the rooms which house all the equipment. I mean, there's so many rooms that really run this auditorium, and to me, they are the incredible thing that we actually put all that together as well. The work behind the scenes, to be honest, it just moves me when I think about it, how much people have put into what we have and what people can see.
Well, behind me, I have a line of men and women who deserve our applause. This is a line of fame. You know, these men and women have served so faithfully for over 18 months now. To qualify for this lineup, basically, they have been here every Saturday or the equivalent thereof for over 18 months. Unfortunately, of course, some of the people could not be with us today, but these present today, I want to shake their hand. Without them, we would not be moving to our new auditorium tomorrow, probably not even this year. These people deserve our congratulations.
The whole place in your head.
Well done.
Don't know how you sleep at night.
Thanks for the opportunity, Peter. It's been great. We'll get it finished next week. Right, mate.
Proud beyond words. There's no way really to describe the feeling that you get when you walk in to the back of the sanctuary and just have a look down at the people worshipping, or even when it's empty. I've just walked in and there's absolutely nobody here. It's just silent. You know, this isn't just I put that nail in over there, or I poured this concrete, or I painted that wall. This is I've sewed my life into this place. It's almost like the building's got a heart. And you can't help but be moved when you walk in here and you just stop for a second. It's not just the goodness of God, which of course is foremost in everything, but it's also just the faithfulness of the people. It's just their attitude and their desire to be a blessing and to do something that's bigger than themselves. That blows me away.
It's great just to look around and see what we've achieved. It's tremendous to think back and just see how far we've come. We've come a long, long way. One thing that struck me when we recently went to England was really it only takes a few people in a country to make a big impact on a country. And I'm hoping that City Impact Church will have a big impact on New Zealand.
Behind the building, there is the spirit of the people, the commitment of the people. There is the attitude that people had to come and give of themselves, the labour of people, the labour of love. And it's built into the church, not only a huge ownership factor, but it's built into the church unity and also a knowledge that, hey, if we can do this, what else can we do?
The vision that God has placed on the house, He's placed within the spirit of every single hand that's put its hand to the work of the house. This surely is the gate of heaven, and we know it now, because we have seen a visitation from our God.